Good morning, this is Pastor Jim Kinsler coming to you from Banks Funeral Home in Lincolnton, Georgia. We're gathered here to rejoice in the resurrection and remember the life of Joyce Isaacson. We thank you for you who are joining us at home, for joining in this time of prayer and reflection and celebration. We gather this day in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried therefore with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sister Joyce. Dear Lord, we thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion and inspiration in our pilgrimage on earth. O God, in your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us your aid, that we may see in death the gate to eternal life, that we may continue our course on earth until confidence by your call. We are reunited with those who have gone before us, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
As we open God's Word, it is a source of strength and comfort to us, but it also can reflect the person and personality of the one we are remembering today. So, as I was looking through the Scriptures and reflecting upon them, I felt led to use a theme of growth, of garden and life that Joyce had a gift of bringing forth from the ground. I know in my own experience, she gave me a number of plants to put in my office. I did not have the gift of gardening that Joyce did, and those vibrant plants that she gave to me ended up withering. So I want to celebrate that gift of life. And the very first psalm paints a picture of a tree planted beside a stream of water. And so, happy are those who do not know, follow the advice of the wicked, but take the path, nor take the path that sinners tread, or sit in the seat of scoffers. But their delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law they meditate day and night. They are like trees planted by streams of water, which yield their fruit in season, and their leaves do not wither, and all that they do, they prosper. So I kind of picture there at the Isaacson house, the trees down by the lake giving shade. And Joyce was one of those big trees, you know, that give shade where people gather under. And so the fruit of her life has been planted into our lives as well. So this day we rejoice in having experienced living in the branches that were spread out in the many ideas that Joyce brought to fruition in her life. In the 15th chapter of 1 Corinthians, it's a chapter that is reflective of the resurrection. And as we gather here today, that is a very important part of what we are doing. We are remembering the resurrection. And Paul uses the image of first fruits of seeds that are planted to remind us of the resurrection. I'm going to read selected verses from the 15th chapter of 1 Corinthians. For I hand on to you as of first importance what I in turn have received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. Then picking up at verse 20, but in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have died. For since death has come through a human being, the resurrection of the dead has also come through a human being. For as all die in Adam, so all will be made alive in Christ, the first fruits that are coming at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then continuing at verse 35, but some will ask, how are the dead raised? With what kind of body do they come? Fool, what you sow does not come to life unless it dies. And as for what you sow, you do not sow the body that is to be, but a bare seed, perhaps of wheat or some other grain. But God gives it a body as he has chosen, and to each kind of seed its own body. Not all flesh is alike, but there is one flesh for a human being and another for animals. And then continuing, as the chapter concludes, beginning at the 51st verse, listen, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all die, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For this perishable body must put on the imperishable, and this mortal body must put on immortality. When this perishable body puts on imperishable, and this mortal body puts on immortality, then shall the saying that is written be fulfilled. Death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. These are words that Joyce lived by as she planted many seeds in the lives of God's people. And our final reading comes from the fourth chapter of Mark's Gospel. And there Jesus uses an illustration of what the kingdom of God is like. He says, again, he began to teach them beside the sea. Such a very large crowd gathered around him that he got into the boat on the sea and sat there while the whole crowd was beside the sea on the land. And he began to teach them many things in parables. And in his teaching, he said to them, listen, a sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seed fell on the path, and the birds came and ate it. Other seed fell on rocky ground, where it did not have much soil, and it sprang up quickly, since it had no depth of soil. And when the sun rose, it was scorched, and since it had no root, it withered away. Other seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it, and it yielded no grain. Other seed fell on good soil and brought forth grain, growing up and increasing and yielding 30 and 60 and 100-fold. And he said, let anyone who has ears, let him hear the gospel of the Lord. Let us pray. Holy God, we pray that we might hear your word at this time, a word of comfort, a word of hope, a word of resurrection. In Jesus' name we pray. Today, as we gather, I would say with Jesus, and modify it a little bit, he who has eyes, let them see. For in the life of Joyce Isaacson, we have seen one who allowed that seed of God's love to be planted in her, but also that seed of God's love being sown through her. Joyce had a way of not only seeing what was, but what could be. And in her business life, she created a company which flourished and grew and bared fruit, yea, some 30, some 60, some 100-fold, and I just heard Mo say some 1,800-fold as the numbers of employees multiplied and the impact spread. But that was not true only in a sense of business, but it was true in a sense of compassion and caring. A member of our congregation said the first day, Sunday, the Isaacsons came to church, they sat next to them, and Gene Randall said to Joyce, after listening to her voice, says, "You need to be in the choir." And the next Sunday, Mo was sitting by himself and said to Gene, "See what you have done," because Joyce was in the choir and using her gifts, her skills, her talents to plant the seeds of worship and praise in the lives of God's people. The song we were listening to as we started this service, "Spirit of the Living God," was a song kind of Joyce used as a theme song in her ministry activities. I remember in her leading of the women's group, they would sing, "Spirit of the Living God, fall afresh on me." When they started the Stevens ministry, which Joyce was instrumental in getting started. Matter of fact, she was on the call committee, which called me to the Lutheran Church by the lake. And one of the things she wanted was a Stevens ministry program. And so, as you might know, what Joyce wanted, Joyce had a way of making happen. And so the Spirit of the Living God fell upon us, and now we have a vibrant Stevens ministry. And one of the things they're doing is they're calling the most vulnerable in our congregation, in our community during this crisis, and checking up on them on a regular basis. So we can see once again that that seed which was planted has grown some 30, some 60, yay, some 100-fold. And so we rejoice in those seeds which Joyce planted. Another thing Joyce did was the ministry of our prayer shawls and our quilts, as she once again saw an opportunity to use something she enjoyed, something she rejoiced in, needlework and knitting, to touch the lives of others. And those quilts have literally gone around the world, and those prayer shawls have been sources of comfort and caring. I know that at this time, as Isaac Mo came home, those quilts in the house, those comforters, were a reminder of that warmth and that love that Joyce had such a real way of sharing with those around her. And so not only in the garden, not only in the Stevens ministry, not only in the quilting ministry, not only in business, but in her family, Joyce had a way of being that tree that we have been blessed to live under the shade of those loving arms. And now we are challenged, but we're also rejoice in remembering, as Paul says, "Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord your labor is not in vain." We have been blessed by eyes to see a good example, and now we are sent forth to live as that example to others as well, to plant those seeds of love, care, compassion, and faith, and may they bear fruit. It was in the season of Lent that Joyce passed away. But it is in the season of Easter that we come together today. And as we do, that season of Easter is a reminder of the resurrection. Mo shared with me just this morning, she said, every Easter that Joyce used to get up and share, "He is risen." And those around her would respond, "He is risen indeed." So I invite you who are at home and those who are gathered here, he is risen. He is risen indeed. And so we remember that Joyce has been raised to new life. She is more alive now than she ever was. And we know that she was very alive when we were able to share with her here on earth as well. It might seem as a coincidence, but I think it is a God incidence. As we were preparing for this service, the family members came across an email, and in it, Joyce had mentioned, if I go first, I would like this psalm to be played. And so he raised me up. So as we hear and listen to this song, please just reflect on the seeds that have been planted in your life that Joyce gave to you. He raised me up. Joyce's life of faith was a source of strength for her. And throughout the centuries, God's people have declared their faith through the Apostles' Creed. God has made us his people through our baptism to Christ, living together in trust and hope. We confess that faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead, and on the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Holy God, we come this day giving you thanks and praise for the promise, the power, and the reality of the resurrection. May that hope and certainty be a source of strength for us. Lord, in your mercy, Holy God, be with us as we continue to walk in our pilgrimage on earth, just as you declared in the 23rd Psalm, walk with us through the valley of the shadow of death, and give us that assurance that comes from your presence. Lord, in your mercy, be with your church on earth. May we, as a community of your people, as the body of Christ, support one another in this time of need. Lord, in your mercy, Lord God, we are mindful of those who have been impacted and affected by the pandemic of the COVID virus. So we pray for all folks who have been touched in some way across the globe. But particularly, Lord, we lift up the Isaacson family. Give them a sense of your presence. Lord, in your mercy. Holy God, of grace, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks because by his death, Jesus destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection has opened the kingdom of God to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also. And Lord God, we place into your loving arms our sister Joyce, receiving her into the everlasting rest you have prepared. And God, make us certain that because Jesus lives, we shall live also, and that neither death, nor life, nor things present, nor things to come shall be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Joyce. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming, receive her into the arms of your mercy and into the blessed rest of everlasting peace and into the company of your saints in light. Amen. For Mo, Kathy, Hudson, and Jason, and for you who are gathered with us at home, we pray. The Lord will bless you and keep you. The Lord will make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. That the Lord will lift up his favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go forth in the peace, power, and promise of the resurrection, which surrounded Joyce in her life and now leads us as we continue to live for the glory of God. In the name of Christ, amen. Amen. Then sings my soul.